Hello, everybody. Welcome. I know it's been a while since I made a video. I've been struggling with things, but I'm getting it worked out. So, I appreciate it if you're here watching this video. We've had a lot of stuff going on. We got a new youngin' coming. She's not going to be much longer. Because Mama's getting ready. She's two doctor's appointments a day and stuff like that. We've had a lot of stuff going on, and it's just been me getting after it as much as I possibly can. And well, sometimes life happens and you just have to deal with it. But I'm glad you're here. We got something here. It's probably something that nobody would expect. But anyway, let's have a look at it. Yep. It's one of the old Polans. This is a 2055. It's basically the same as a Wild Thing or any of the other ones that go along with that manner. I've already taken the top cover screws loose. This thing doesn't run. Don't know how long it's been since it has ran, and the fella that owns it wants to see if we can get it fixed, and I said, yep, bring it on over and we'll see what we can do with it. So I'm gonna try to show y'all some of the stuff that I usually go through. This is the air filter out of it. If you're gonna start doing one of these, something's been sitting for a while, get you an air filter, because it's like old cake. It looks like a filter, but it don't act like one anymore. So I'm gonna try to ease through this and see if we can figure out what we got going on here. It's really tight. That's the first time I pulled the rope, so we're gonna check it out. One of the things that I like to do is spray a little something in it and see if it'll fire off. I don't always recommend doing that with brake cleaner, but I'm gonna give it just a little bit and see if it buzzes. Alright, so we know it will run. Now I know the primer bubble's rotted off of it. It's gonna get a new chain. Looks like the clutch cover isn't on right. So I'm just gonna go ahead and we're just gonna take a T20 and snap these bolts out of it right quick so we can get into the working part of it. Because I'm not gonna try to give y'all a super long video since it's been a while. I don't want you to have to sit and watch me just do a bunch of random stuff. A lot of the stuff that I've been doing has just been so repetitive, that's the reason why I hadn't been filming it. There's just bokoodles of things that I've done so much stuff, I just don't have a whole lot left to show over and over and over and over and over and over. So I know these videos, people seem to really like it, getting these little cheaper saws running, so we're going to see if we can do this one right fast, quick, and in a hurry. I may not film all of it real hard because I need to clean the carburetor too, so I might go on and do that. I'm just going to set the screws up here. The fuel lines are, you know. So, pop this carburetor off here. Pump the choke off of it. These things, you can usually pull them up and take it off. There's the carburetor. And here is the fuel lines. just breaking up so bad I grabbed them with the tweezers and they just fall to pieces. But that's what the fuel line looks like right now. That just disintegrated. They're just disintegrating. Phillips screw for the primer bubble. And I'm going to try to show which line goes where and how you can tell. As you can see, it's just rotten. It's just plumb rotten. Right, I'm going to throw this in the trash because, well, we don't need it. Because we have new stuff. I'm going to move y'all over here in just a second. Let's try to throw some of that stuff in the trash and not on the floor. There's a choke cable. Alright. I'm going to pause it for a minute, and then we're going to get back after it. Let's see what the inside of the fuel tank looks like. Let's see if we can get this fuel line out of here right quick. Yeah, it's rotten. It is rotten. All right, I'm going to go blow this thing off right quick. All right, I got it cleaned up. Well, cleaned up good enough anyway. This next bit, if you do one of these, this might make some people a little nervous. It doesn't really bother me. I've done it a blue million times. This is a 3/16 drill bit. It's 187 thousandths. This is some Black Echo trimmer line. I buy it from the Duke, Traverse Creek, Pennsylvania. I think this is actually 5 or 6 millimeter. I'm not even sure. I'll measure it and tell you. It's somewhere around 5 millimeter. And this drill bit's 471. Now, the main fuel line goes right here, the back of this thing. We're just going to go straight down through there and drill it out. And then the return line goes right here. Or this, I think this is actually the main fuel line. The main fuel line is the little one over on the side. We don't want that anymore. We don't want that little line. We want the big line. I'm just going to take my deburring tool and just try to reach down in there and turn it just on top of it a little bit, which just puts just a little bit of a chamfer on the hole. Might make it a little easier to pull the line in. That one down there is a real, it's not so easy to get to. You can just use a bigger drill bit too, which is probably what I ought to do. Just take a larger drill bit if you don't have a deburring tool. Just hit it like that. It just takes that sharp lip off top of the hole. Makes it easier for you to pull your fuel line in. So we got that. Now, this is all fuel line I've got left. I gotta get some more. And, I hate having to cut these ends off every time, but we're gonna push it through there. And I'm gonna see if I can reach in there and get a hold of it. reaching in there to get a hold of it. It's not the easiest thing to do. If you got a pair of these hemostats, it sure does make it easier. If you don't have a pair, I recommend getting a pair. If you're going to do this kind of stuff on a regular basis. I'm just going to try to push a little bit more through. And if maybe I can see the end of it. I haven't got there yet. Because sometimes getting it through there without cutting a good little portion of it off is a real pain. See, just trimming it down like that so I can put it through and pull it in. Now I can see a little bit of it. And that's what you're after right there. Now, we're going to slap the card back on it for a minute because I want to... I want to keep as much fuel line as possible without trimming any of it off that I don't have to. So I'm going to set it back down in there. This line is going to go to the top nipple on this side. Now we've got to get a little bit in there. If I can actually show you all this or not. See where the fuel line goes to the top nipple and turns and goes back down into the tank. That's the feed line for the carburetor. So now we're gonna be cutting it close, and I mean close. We're just barely going to have enough fuel line, looks like. Because getting that next one in might be a little bit of a chore. We'll cut it right there. We're going to open this box of new stuff, which is our new air filter, our new fuel filter, our new primer bubble. Fuel filter on there, and I'm gonna get a small zip tie to put on there as a clamp. All right, I'm gonna take a small zip tie, just go around the fuel line and just cinch it tight. I've been using these for a while now, and they actually make pretty good hose clamps. Now I'm gonna grab it like this, and before I cut it, I'm gonna turn it. And then snip it off. And that drop just gives you a little bit of leverage to drop tight. I'll drop that in there, and it's sitting on the bottom. Looks good. We're gonna push this fuel line through the next hole on the right side. Take the carburetor back off. We're just gonna push this one down through here. This is on the right side of the tank if you're standing behind it. This one's going to go to the primer bubble. Purge bubble, whatever you want to call it. It's going to go right there. Now I'm trying to see about how much I need to take off of there. Cause this is no exact size to this. I'm gonna try to get it right there and pull it over here. I'm gonna cut it right here at my hemostats. Because I want to put, you just don't want to pull it all the way through. But once you get that on there like that, grab back a hold of it. You got this little thing. Just put it in the end of this line and then pull it back till it hits. And that stops the line from being able to come up out of the tank. Stand there like that. Well, cover everything over. There you go. That's in there now. And this one will reach to over here to the primer bubble. I'm trying to go underneath the throttle linkage. I'm going to go underneath the kill switch wires in the throttle linkage with all the lines. All right, now those are your two main feeds. Now the other line just goes from the bubble over to the carburetor. And we may have to use a piece of the of this line for that. But I can change this line outside without having to worry about putting it back through the tank. All right. I'm going to pop the caps off the carb and see what that looks like right quick. All right. I got the caps off of it. This is the reason why we do this. Listen. Oh. It's dried completely out and just, there it comes. All right, there's that one. Now, I don't know how much of this y'all can see. I'm trying to keep it where you can see as much. I'm a little rusty on my filming for obvious reasons. One of these days, I hope I can find somebody that can come in here and help me so we can make higher quality, better videos for y'all. Bad thing is, I'm not able to pay somebody to do it, and that's the worst part. But, yeah, Mama says she's going to help me some after she has the baby, so we'll see. Come on. Some of this stuff I don't film because it just takes so long. This is one of the things. I should be using my dull razor knife instead of my sharp new one. The dull one scrapes over it easier. And I do sharpen this thing regular, but it still ain't sharp like a sharp one. Clean the fire out of it right quick. That's the high needle. Here's the low needle. And the low needle, I think, should be longer. It is, not by much, but it is. They're also different sizes. So, let me take the meter and needle out. Trying to make it where y'all can see, and it's hard for me to see it, let alone show y'all. Let's take the screw all the way out. There we go. All right, now it's opened up. I gotta find my straw. Hold on a minute. All right, now.
There's a little brass thing right here. I don't know how much of this y'all be able to see. I'm trying to get it right off the edge of the table here. I'm gonna go down through the needle hole. Make sure it's open. I'm gonna go down through this loading valve, basically is what it is. It's a one-way check valve for the needle jets. I don't know if y'all can see that coming out there or not, but you want to make sure that one's open, because if it's not, it'll never flow fuel through it. And the screen's flowing. We're going to wash the screen out good. And everything else seems to be going to go through the needle holes. Spitting out inside the carburetor looks good. So we're gonna do what I call a quick clean on this one. Well, I just clean it real quick, put it back together, and see if it runs. Because these carburetors, unfortunately, you have two options. It either runs or it don't run. I'm gonna get a new needle and a new gasket set to put in it, and we'll put it back together. All right, I moved all the old stuff off the table. Here's the new stuff we're gonna use. This is the new needle. I just went and got it out of the box. Now y'all seeing this is probably gonna be a negative. I could have just thrown it back in there, but I'll at least let y'all watch me struggle. Get this little needle. And the little spring goes right there in that slot. There's a little space for that little spring to sit. It goes right there, and you have to put the needle in the lever and have your pin in there. And you got to set it all down on top of that spring without knocking the spring out. And with all of it put together, not like that. It just does not want to set up. Give me a second. All right. I don't know if y'all can see that, but I put just a little tiny dab of blue grease on the end of that spring. That way when I push him down there in the hole, that stays there even when I set the car back on the side. All right. Put the needle back on the lever. Like that. And we're going to try to set it back down in there again. And there we go. Now, I got all that set back down in there. I'm holding it with my thumb, so I'm going to try to drop this screw in here and get the meter and lever tightened back down. All right. Now, I got the adjustment and it's too low. You check the meter and lever with that. We're gonna raise him up like so and check it again. Looks like we're right on there. And I dropped my back scratcher in the floor, so. And I just realized I got the wrong diaphragm. Because the one that it needs got the nipple on it, this one does not. So let me get the other diaphragm. See the little nipple sticking up off of that diaphragm? Some of them don't have that. And if it doesn't have it, and you put one on there that doesn't, and it needs it, then it won't work. because it won't push the meter and leave her. Ask me how I knew. Because I've done it before. I never figured out what was wrong with that a long time ago. A long time ago. Get the screws back in here. And this is basically real time. I mean, the only time I stopped was just to go over and get stuff. So if you ever wonder how long it takes to clean a carburetor, it's not that long if it works when you're done. Now that's a big if, because sometimes they do not work when you're done and you have to tear them apart and work on them repeatedly. And sometimes you can do it 15, 20 times and it still won't work when you're done because the carburetor just isn't any good anymore. Rarely does that happen, but it does happen. Now we're gonna use this blue diaphragm that come out of it because I prefer them over any other one that's made. And they usually don't give any trouble, so we're putting a new gasket on it. And the old diaphragm. Because they're made out of a hard plastic membrane, and the blue ones seem to work real well for everything. Alcohol, gasoline. I think they'll even stand up to some nitromethane. There's that. We got two jets to put back in. The low jet. I'm going to run it all the way in till it bottoms out, which is right there. Now I'm going to go half turn, one half turns. I used to set them on one, but some of these are a little bit lean on one, so I'm going to set them at one and a half, and then we'll run them back in to lean it out a little bit if that's what we need to do. We'll run this one all the way until it locks, then half turn, one full turn, one and a half turns. Now, we've got our carburetor where we want it. Pull our camera back up here. And we're going to start putting them back on there. I'm going to put this on. Sorry if you're looking at the back of my head. It goes down in there like that. I'm going to slide that fuel line on that top one. I'm going to take a piece of this. Come over through here. And come up. And like I said, this yellow line is not always the best line, but this is not an authentic Tygon. I'm going to put this one on the bottom one. I'm going to twist it around over like that. I'm going to pull just a little bit more of it in and snip them off. Now, everything's on there that we need. Our primer bubble. Everybody's always asking, which one do you use? All right. I squeeze the bubble, put my finger over the end, and see how that holds? See how it holds in? That is the suction one. The little short one is the suction one. The suction one comes from the side of the carburetor. Because what you're going to do when you pump the primer bubble is you're going to pull fuel. You're going to pull a vacuum on the carburetor and it's going to suck the gas up through the filter and into the carburetor. You're not trying to pump it in. You're trying to draw it in. So the little short one is the suction line. It goes to the carburetor. The other one is the return. Goes back to the tank. That goes to the push side. We're going to slide it up on there. Find our two little screws. Put them back in. Why I'm so jittery is beyond me. I actually ate lunch just a little bit ago. But sometimes my back has just been giving me some trouble and stuff here and there, so sometimes it makes my hands jittery. There, those are on there. Where's the... I'm going to pull this back up, stick this back on there before I push the carburetor down all the way, because it's hard to get that on once you have the carburetor bolted down. I'm going to pop the choke lever back in there. Maybe. I said we're going to pop the choke lever back in there. Make sure the throttle works. It does not. It's binding up on something. What are we binding up on? Oh. Oh, we got handle issues. Something's going on with the handle, and I do not know what it is. Let me have a look and see if I can figure that out. I pulled the throttle stop out of the dead man switch and the throttle itself out of it. I've never taken one of these out before, so I'm just looking at it to see if I can figure out what's going on with it. So if I see anything weird, I'll let you know. Right now, it just looks like everything was rusty, so I'm probably going to clean it up and just stick it back in there. Well, that was exciting. It was a royal pain, I tell you that. I got it in there as good as it's going to get. Because, well, he didn't want to spend a whole lot of money on this thing, so I got it back where it'll function now. The pin right here was really rusty. All I'd probably had to done was pop that out, clean it up, put it back in there, but the... spring it goes under is kind of bent too, so see, there's our new air filter. It's going to go right there. I did blow the gas tank out. There's a little bit of stuff still in there, but the majority of it come out. Let's put the side cover on it, see if it'll prime up. And see if it'll crank. Because this video is already getting to be 30 some minutes long. Mama called me. I answered the phone and it reset my video. So I'll have to go in there and edit the video to make it whole again. But nonetheless, hopefully she's going to fire up right here in just a minute. And we'll be able to try it out and see what happens. Maybe the gas cap won't leak too bad. Put a little go-go juice in it. Screw the cap on, screw this cap back on, see how bad it leaks. Probably everywhere. So far not. We're going to crank it in here and see if it'll crank before we take it outside and try to adjust on it. And no fire. this is the reason a lot of people don't work on these things. Well, this is what can happen sometimes. Spend an hour or so working on it, and then it will not start off the carburetor. We're going to see if it's flooded, which I think it is. Let it know. All right. Give me a minute. It tried to crank. Unfortunately, you have some that ran perfect and some that do not. And right now, this is one that do not. So, I'm going to use the redneck electric start on it. If it'll stay on there, see what happens. This is the stuff that a lot of people don't show you. Yep, that's what I thought. What I was afraid of, nut come right off. Now it acts like it don't have a heap and helping it. This time. That's what I was talking about. You never know what you're going to get with these. The way this one's acting, I'm just about to say it's going to have a carburetor.
Oh.
intake has an air leak. Oh, mercy. All right. I don't know if I'm going to film that or not.
I made him a price on this thing, and it was pretty low. And he really didn't want to spend that much on it. So I might just stop for a minute. I'll pull the carburetor back off, check, see if screws are tight. Go from there. If you can, you might get to see it cut here shortly. We'll just have to see. I got it to run. Don't ask me, I pulled the trigger on it. It fired off, the screws were just way out of adjustment. Now whether it'll start back or not now, we'll find out. I'm gonna add this in here somewhere. Video might be a little screwy, but you'll get the gist of it. If you see this and then the ending, yeah, that's probably, in a minute you're probably going to see me not getting it to crank, but I did. Try it again later. All right, now for the terrible ending where I can't get it to start. Y'all be good. All right, I pulled the intake off, put a new gasket, a little sealer, some Loctite on the threads. We're gonna see if it'll run this time. I don't have any wood out here right now, so the main thing is we just want to see if it's going to crank and run. I haven't tried to start it since I got done with it, so it might be a pulling fest like it was earlier. Hopefully not. Let's see what happens. Come on, Bethy. Wanting to go. Just ain't. Come on now. Been the best way to start a video for sure. I have no earthly idea why it's acting like this. Sometimes you win some, sometimes you don't. This video is already way too long. So, well, we're gonna put how to change fuel lines. I'm gonna stop here because I'm extremely irritated. All right, y'all. Y'all have a good day. Stay safe, be kind, treat each other the way you wanna be treated. God bless, remember, Jesus loves you. Bellhopper out.